Hey folks, my name is John Belutsky from SeeMeForLife.com. My whole goal is to help you maximize your mind. Now, in reviewing the ACLS algorithms, now I've had the pleasure of running lots of codes and teaching a lot of ACLS programs, but I also say this with a lot of humility. As a PA, I mean, I'm not a master at ACLS. Not at all. That's the cardiologist stuff. That's really what the emergency physicians do. But when you're put in a position to care for those who are critically ill, you give them everything you got. That's what I've always done. Now, one of the questions that I've had and I've seen and I've experienced is the wide complex tachyarrhythmias. Those patients that are wide complex tachyarrhythmia. Now, the new algorithms talk about an adenosine challenge. If it's a wide complex of uncertain origin, try adenosine. And I've asked a lot of people this question. I've asked residents this question. Hey, if you have someone with a wide complex tachyarrhythmia, use adenosine and a brake, what can you infer from that? I mean, what information can you get from that? And if you know, adenosine is kind of like a vagal nerve stimulator. It's a pharmacologic vagal nerve stimulator. The vagus nerve plugs into the AV node. So it would be intuitive to say if you give someone adenosine with a wide complex tachyarrhythmia and they slow down, it must be AV node or higher. That would make anatomical sense. That's what I thought. That's what the residents that I talk to think. It's not true. It's not accurate. It's not accurate, and it's a misunderstanding. I just recently listened to a speech that Amal Mattoo gave, who I think is a brilliant teacher, and I learned tremendous amounts from. He introduced me to the concept of adenosine-responsive ventricular tachycardia, and he talks about being well proven in the literature there are certain breeds of VTAC that do indeed break from adenosine. Now, wait, what would this mean? What would it mean? Well, if you have someone that breaks from adenosine, you could easily make the argument that it must have been an SVT with aberrant conduction or left bundle branch block. You would treat them different. You'd think about them different. A patient who's in VTAC, I mean, you have sphincter sign. You pucker up. You go, oh, man, they have VTAC. Ooh, we got them out of it, either pharmacologically or you zapped them. But it's a big deal. It ranks in emergency medicine as a big deal, where SVT ranks as a no big deal, a very little deal. You can make a mistake. It's kind of like mistaking an otitis media, a febrile kid with otitis media, for a kid with meningitis. They're different animals totally. VTAC is a different animal than SVT. So I'm going to challenge you to research adenosine-responsive VTAC and be very careful about that part of the algorithms that talk about using adenosine in a wide complex tachyarrhythmia of uncertain origin. Could get you into some trouble. Folks, my name is John Belutsky at See Me for Life. My whole goal is to help you maximize your mind, study hard, practice with integrity, maximize your mind.